Hi guys, welcome back. Welcome to everybody who is a new subscriber because of the Independent Bookshop Week tag. Welcome to everybody who's a new subscriber because of finding us from another booktuber. And welcome back if you've been a subscriber for a long time. It's all good. It's lovely to see you all. Last week I was talking about Fen by Daisy Johnson. Fantastic debut story collection. A writer that I'm already very excited about. And my enthusiasm must have been quite infectious because there were lots of comments underneath that video and lots of enthusiasm, which I'm very pleased to see, because I hope you will go and read that book if you're not one of the two lucky people to win a copy. It is fantastic, and as I say, very excited about her future, which is a good thing. I did have two copies to give away, and the lucky people winning those are Layla Ashton and Amira Al-Ghahari. Congratulations, both of you. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description, and if you send me your postal addresses, I will get those books off to you as soon as I can. This week, I finally get to talk to you about a book that I read absolutely ages ago, and I've been wanting to talk to you about it, and finally the day has arrived, because it is published. It is a book I have spoken about before to some people. I spoke to Jen about it on her podcast, and I'm sure I've spoken to plenty of you on Twitter or elsewhere about this book. Because it's fab. This is the book, It's the Girls by Emma Cline. Now let's start off by saying that when I first heard about this book and when I saw the proofs, it is not the kind of book that I probably would have reached for. I don't know whether that's because it's called The Girls and that the fact that it's about a girl. I've never been a 14-year-old girl in my life, and so I guess there's part of me that sort of thought, I don't know how interested I am in that book or will be or how much I'm going to be able to relate to it. Which probably says more about my sort of reading habits than anything else. But I think that's okay. I think it's okay to sort of, obviously, to easily be able to engage with books that are more like you or your life. And then, obviously, to get a lot back from books which might be about a version of you in a different time or place, or even somebody completely different to you in a different time or place. But there's sort of always something slightly touristic about that. And often the books that we really connect with are the ones that have some either massive connection to who we are or some really clear universal themes that sort of apply to everybody. So yeah, I guess I wasn't sort of thinking I want to read this book, which is set in 1969 in California and is about a 14-year-old girl. But my God, am I glad that I did, because it's a frighteningly well-written debut novel. Emma Cline is an insanely talented writer. And I know this because I now know what it feels like to be a 14-year-old girl in 1969 in California, because she is brilliant at the sort of psychology of being a girl of that age. And I guess I can't sort of say that with any knowledge. I can't say, well, that's exactly what it was like for me, because I've never been there. But I totally believe her portrait of Evie in this book. I totally believe the motivations of her and her friends. And it's so important to believe it, because what this book is really looking at is, if you don't know about the Charles Manson case or the Manson family, just do a quick Google. You'll quickly find out. It's a sort of charismatic cult leader in America in the late 60s who was responsible for sort of inciting this violence that ended up with the murder of Sharon Tate, who was this actress who was the girlfriend of the film director Roman Polanski at the time. And what's the question it's really asking, I suppose, and the question that was asked at the time was, how could these young girls have done this thing? What gets you into that state of mind that you would join a community like this in the first place, perhaps, but also to be motivated to go out and commit an act of violence like that? And what better way to investigate that than by putting a character in amongst these people and to see what happens. And there's something very particular, I think, about the girls in this case. It's about being a certain age. It's about being on the cusp of womanhood. It's about having this burgeoning sexual power over men and not necessarily knowing what to do with it. It's about suddenly having lots of eyes on you and knowing that that means something, but not really knowing quite what to do with that power. And that is so fascinating and so brilliantly handled by Emma Cline in this book. I now feel like I have a much better understanding of not just this particular case, but I think that sort of the idea of communal living and how that infects how you think about other people. It's so brilliant about the person that Evie truly, I suppose, loves in this book is not any of the men. It is another girl. It's about that incredibly close female friendship thing that can happen around that age as well. It's about so much, and it's so well handled. And what I really liked about the book was that it doesn't just simply tell the story of Evie in that time period. It is narrated by Evie looking back on that time period, and we see her much older. And I think it's really important to have that that other viewpoint, I suppose, to see the maturity of somebody looking back on a period in their life. And I think what it shows there is if you are part of something that is so newsworthy, so monumental, what does that mean for the rest of your life? How does it affect you going forwards? And might it be something that you never, ever escape from? Just so much in there. So I loved reading this book. It's the kind of thing that I read it really quickly because I was completely engrossed. There is something thrilling about the page-turning sort of appeal of this book. It also looks fantastic. There is something about the aesthetic of California 1969 summer hippie chicks that we all know so well because it's just such common currency, that. But it's a beautiful image here taken by a renowned photographer called Neil Krug. There's actually an article on our website where he and our creative director, Suzanne Dean, who is a genius, talk about how they created this cover, how that sort of collaboration happened. I'll put a link for that down below this video. You'll also be able to read an extract from the girls. There'll be a link for that as well. And there will also be a link to an interview with Emma where she is talking in this very room. You may recognise the red background about the book and about why she felt compelled to write it and some of the background to it and stuff like that. She's very lovely and very intelligent and very empathetic. And I think that's what you get from reading this book, is that she really she's a great guide, a great writer to get you inside Evie's head. And as I said, I have never been a 14-year-old girl, but I feel like I have now after reading this book, because it really puts you there through everything that she goes through. That vulnerability is so powerful. You really feel it. And I was very worried for her at several points in this book. And that kind of investment, that thing where you really care about a character, is, I think, much harder to pull off than it looks. So when it works, it really does work. So there we go. That is what I'm going to say about the girls. As you can tell, I really liked it. But I don't think I need to sell it to you too much, because look at it. It's a beautiful thing. And I think the people who are going to enjoy reading this book, you probably know who you are already. So there you go. The Girls by Emma Cline, which was published yesterday. As ever, I have two copies to give away. So if you fancy your chances, make sure you're subscribed, leave a comment below, and two lucky people will win copies next week. That is all for this week. Thank you for joining me again, and I'll see you next week. Take care.